Hello everyone, today I will introduce a multifunctional test fixture for testing Avalon hashboards. This explanation includes the functions of the fixture, and how to use it. First, let's introduce the main interfaces of the fixture and their corresponding functions. These two are the positive and negative pole interfaces, clearly marked on the board. Plus represents the positive pole, and minus represents the negative pole. They are used to connect to the hashboard and provide power to it. These two are powering interfaces for the tester. When using a PC power supply, we need to connect both with a powering voltage of 12 volts. This is the foot switch interface, which controls the fixture to test the hashboard. If using the original PSU of the miner, these three interfaces need to be connected. For hashboard models below the 1066 Pro, connect to this interface on the left. For testing 1066 Pro, 11 series, and 12 series hashboards, plug the original power supply's interface into this middle one. Of course, for testing the A1346 hashboard, we also connect to this 6P power interface, but also need to connect this 4P communication protocol connector. This is the USB interface for connecting to a computer, facilitating the viewing of test logs and troubleshooting. Here is the control board firmware flashing connector, which connects the fixture and control board for firmware burning. These two are the ribbon cable interfaces for connecting the hashboard. For models below the 1066 Pro, connect to this black interface. For testing 1066 Pro, 11 series, 12 series, and 1346 hashboards, connect to the white interface. During the repair process, if short-circuiting the D signal is required, we need to use this interface. The white rotary button on the left is for selecting the ASIC chip model of the hashboard being tested. For example, if the ASIC chip is A3200, we need to turn this knob to zero and press it down. They represent different chip models. See 4A3200C chips. 0 4A3200 chips. 1 4A3201 chips. 2 4A3202 chips. 3 4A3203. 4 4A3204 chips. 5 4A3205 chips. The black knob on the right is for selecting different modes. N for normal testing mode, which tests for hashboard faults, T for signal measurement, also to measure related voltages, such as domain voltage, boost voltage, LDO powering voltage, and oscilloscope waveforms of the signal. If short-circuiting the D signal and looking for faults, we need to turn this to F mode. The rest are cyclic, and have the same function. Now, let's continue explaining these indicator lights. When testing the hashboard, if the OK light is on, it means there are no faults. Otherwise, if the NG light is on, the hashboard has a fault. If this middle indicator light is on, it means the cable connection and hashboard powering are normal. If the MT light on the right is on, it indicates that the ribbon cable connection between the hashboard and the test fixture is normal, otherwise, it's abnormal. Next, we will continue to introduce the functions and connections of these cables. The USB cable, one end connects to the test fixture, and the other end to the computer. Once connected, we can view the test logs on the computer for troubleshooting. These two are hashboard data ribbon cables for connecting the hashboard and test fixture. The wide gray one connects to hashboards with models below the 1066 Pro. The other one connects to 1066 Pro, 11 series, 12 series, and 1346 hashboards. This one is a foot switch. After connecting, step on it with your foot to control the tester to output signal and voltage to test the hashboard. This is a red and black alligator clip power cable, used to connect the test fixture and hashboard, mainly for powering the hashboard. This is a clip for short-circuiting the D signal. If burning firmware to the control board, this ribbon cable is needed. Alright, now I will demonstrate how to use this test fixture to test a hashboard. Step 1. Connect the related cables of the test fixture. Today, I chose the Avalon A1166 Pro hashboard for the demonstration, and its chip model is A3200. Step 2. Connect the data ribbon cable to the hashboard, then the positive and negative power cords. Don't connect them incorrectly, or it will burn out the hashboard. Of course, during testing, we need to use a cooling fan to cool the hashboard. Step 3. Power up the PC PSU to power the test fixture. The chip model is A3200, so here we turn to number 0, and press the button. Then turn the right side to N to enter normal testing mode. Okay, this part of the setup is complete. Continue to set up the testing software on the computer. We need to check the port of the fixture connected to the computer's USB in the device manager, double-click COM5, and check the port settings in the pop-up window, remembering it must be 115,200. Here I am using this software to display the test logs, but other serial software can also be used. Double-click the software. Then click the plus sign to open the serial port, and check that these parameters match the computer settings. Everything ready, step on the foot switch to start testing the hashboard. After the test is complete, we can release the foot switch. Displayed here are the test results. With this fixture, we can easily detect faults in the hashboard. Next, we will learn how to short-circuit the D signal. During the repair process, if these two situations occur, we will short-circuit the D signal. 1. Not all ASIC chips detected. 2. If the voltage or oscilloscope waveform of the C and CK signals are normal, but the specific fault is still not found, we can use the method of short-circuiting the D signal to pinpoint the fault. Insert the short-circuit probe into the test fixture. Then turn the black knob to F mode. It's important to note that the plus on the probe represents the positive pole, which can also be identified by this red tape placed on the D signal. The other probe pin is the negative pole, which can be placed on either the positive or negative pole of the chip being tested. Of course, when short-circuiting the D signal, we also need to step on the foot switch. For example, short-circuiting the D signal of this chip, correctly connect the probe, step on the foot switch. And the test log shows that 5 ASIC chips have been found, which is normal. Let's demonstrate short-circuiting the D signal of the 8th chip, using the same method and steps. The log shows 8 chips found, indicating that chips 1 to 8 have no faults. However, if a number less than 8 is displayed here, it means that one of the chips is abnormal, and we need to continue short-circuiting the D signal for further investigation. For instance, short-circuiting the D signal of the 8th chip, if the log shows 6, it means chips 1 to 6 are normal, and either chip 7 or 8 has a fault. Then continue to short-circuit chips 7 and 6 to accurately locate the faulty chip. We continue using the T position of the measurement mode. In this mode, we can measure related voltages and signal waveforms. When measuring, don't forget to step on the foot switch. Set the multimeter to the DC voltage gear. Measure the domain voltage, which is around 0.3 volts. Measure the LDO powering, which are 1.8 volts and 0.75 volts respectively. Then use the test fixture and oscilloscope to measure the signal waveform. First, we need to clip the oscilloscope's probe to the hashboard's negative pole. Then measure the each signal waveform of the chip in turn. Step on the foot switch is very important. As the video demonstrates, it is possible to quickly detect whether the signal is normal from the waveform. Alright, the Avalon multifunctional test fixture is easy to use and powerful. In the next video, I will introduce how to use this fixture to flash firmware to the control board. Welcome to subscribe the channel and discuss. Thank you everyone.